time is running out. Limiting global warming to 2 degrees requires capping carbon emissions at a trillion tons, and we're already more than halfway there. So mitigating climate change is now both critical and urgent, yet still, it's not enough. We need to be able to forecast climate risks, and we need to become resilient to a new reality, which looks like this. Worldwide natural catastrophes have more than doubled since 1980. Staying resilient to weather extremes will prove imperative to utilities and the societies they serve. But accurately predicting those extremes is impossible because of countless uncertainties. The magnitude of change will be variable, but extreme events are becoming business as usual. Indeed, weather-related disturbances to the electricity network increased tenfold since 1992 in the U.S. And the whole power sector value chain will need to adapt, with each plant or transmission infrastructure facing specific and variable local risks. There's immense pressure on utilities, especially when growing cities expand into climate-exposed areas. It makes resilience more difficult and expensive for companies expected to provide service 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Responding to climate change involves 5 common elements. Power companies will need to anticipate weather events with improved forecasting, plan their precise requirements for power infrastructure, inform customers, businesses, and local authorities about potential weather impacts and action plans. They'll need to respond by having a flexible plan organized, and recover by replacing damaged assets and incorporating learnings and best practices in future plans. Specifically, how each power company addresses these 5 elements will depend on the level of risk it wants to take, how flexible it can be, and how interconnected it is with other companies. By modeling potential risks against investment possibilities, utilities can determine what losses could be averted. The power sector is already taking action and will continue to do more as the risks are better understood. Synergies can be created by working together to build resilient communities. Policymakers can create frameworks that enable resilience in business and community decision-making. And all areas of society should collaborate, share the burden, scale up resilience measures, and understand interdependences. As part of Action 2020, the WBCSD will build on the Electric Utilities Project by examining resilience across a range of supply chains. You can learn more about how to scale up power sector resilience and join global efforts at WBCSD.org.